Angelo with Slayer Valdez. We have Lauren Cook, escorted by Brian Matthews. We have Sarah Kirksey, escorted by Derek Brunier. We have Allie Kello, escorted by Steve Lupo. We have Kelsey Crawford, escorted by Michael Van Hoyer. Catherine Fan, escorted by Dan Bloom. We have Brittany Schultz, escorted by Sam Moore.
Thanks a lot, Tony. anymore because I ditched them to hang out with my boyfriend. So I needed to find a new group of friends that accepted me for exactly who I am. And I remember going to a party and seeing Izzy and her, and just feeling so comfortable just being exactly who I am. We were friends throughout high school. You know, we hung out, we did the whole Beyox thing, Brittany, Izzy, Ali, Kelsey.
Yeah, yeah.
Shall we? But I do remember though that I had a bunch of people over to my parents' house. Well, it was Timothy. And Allison, stop. I had a bunch of people over like the last day of summer before we all went to college. And I was freaking out going to college without my best friend. And I remember her telling me, like, you're gonna be fine. Everything's gonna be fine. We're gonna kick ass at the zoo. And that's the thing about Izzy is that she always knew exactly what to tell me to make me feel better about myself. Because I have struggled with anxiety my entire life. And Izzy, she knows me better than I know myself. And she has always been the person that I can go to when I'm feeling overwhelmed. I mean, not going to college with your best friend is hard. It's extremely hard. But I'm so thankful for the people that I've met. You're Izzy. You guys are amazing. The first time I did go is at SEMO.
Every night.
we would buy Break and Bake cookies by the dozen. And to a point where, and also, I got hooked on The Bachelor, The Bachelorette, and I called her one night freaking out that JoJo wasn't going to pick the right freaking guy. That's truly how ridiculous I am. But, you know, again, before her bachelorette party, I will say this. Izzy had texted me. Izzy knows that I struggle with anxiety for forever. And before her bachelorette party, she had texted me and said, "Are you okay? Is everything all right?" And I was like, "What are you talking about? Like, this is about you. It's not about me." But she told me she knew how overwhelmed and anxious I get before big events. I really don't like being out in big crowds. I'm more of a homebody. And I remember, you know, venting to her a little bit. I didn't want to disappoint her. I wanted her to have the time of her life. And I didn't want anything to go wrong because I knew it would be on my shoulders. And I remember her telling me, "Everything's gonna be fine. And I love you for who you are, anxiety and all." And that meant the world to me.
You rocked it, girl.
I put a lot of pressure on myself to deliver a great bachelorette party. And I just wanted Izzy to have the time of her life. And the one thing about Izzy is that no matter what's going on in the world, if I text her and say, "I just need you to tell me everything's okay," she does it without question. And that means the world to me. Because that's truly all I need, is for someone to tell me, "Everything's gonna be okay, you're fine." And not a lot of, a lot of my friends just don't understand my anxiety level. And I'm so thankful that you do, because it means the world to me. Justin, you are so lucky to get to call this wonderful woman your wife. But she's just as lucky to have you by her side through this adventure called marriage. So, if I could, can everyone raise their glass? Justin and Izzy, I love you both.
Caveman is when you take a but you like you break it open on your head and you chug it from there. So Justin had a little problem with doing the caveman. He like took the beer and slammed it on his head over and over, and then finally busted it open and drank like what little beer he could out of it. And then you know, we went back and after drinking, we're in our dorm rooms and he's like, I think I had a concussion. It was so funny. He just took me and slammed it. But like, that's an example of something I'm not gonna mention. Well, it would be inappropriate. He's a respected figure. Like, I won't talk about that. Like, another example, I'm not gonna mention his love of strip clubs.
Justin, your dad, Jared, my dad, my home away from home dad, he's watching down at you. He's beyond proud of you. You're 26 years old. You've accomplished so much. You have such an amazing life ahead of you. You have an amazing life with Izzy. Izzy, you look beautiful, by the way. I know he's unbelievably proud of the man that you've become and are becoming, as am I. So I know that we are blood brothers for life. So we'll do a toast to Justin and Izzy. And to my brother, made this so far, and the amazing life ahead of them. I can't wait to be part of it. Cheers.
Couple more important than either of you separately. So today, your friends and family surround you as you begin something new and exciting. Remember your promises. Keep them with all your heart. And you will have that sense of joy and wonder that exceeds all you have ever known. With all my heart, and Mom and I offer our congratulations and warmest wishes as you begin the latest adventure life has to offer. So raise your glasses and offer Izzy and Justin a long, happy life.
They say love is more precious than gold. It can't be bought and it can't be sold. I got love enough to spare. That makes me a millionaire. I got a woman with eyes that shine.
There's two things I know for sure. She was sent here from heaven, and she's daddy's little girl. As I drop to my knees by her bed at night, she talks to Jesus, and I close my eyes, and I thank God for all of the joy. But most of all, for butterfly kisses.
All right, everybody give it up to the groom and his mom. What a beautiful tribute.